What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Let's solve this math question, which says find x for which x plus 2 times x plus 3 times x plus 4 times x plus 5 all over x minus 2 times x minus 3 times x minus 4 times x minus 5 is equal to 1. Well, our first step will be for us to observe what we have, and notice that when I multiply this first term with the last term, I'm going to produce 7x. And when I multiply this second term and this third term, I'm going to produce 7x as well. So there are like terms. So what will happen with that will be for me to rearrange. So let me say rearrange. So on rearranging, we have x plus 2 paired with x plus 5. Very good. And then we have x plus 3. So x plus 3 paired with x plus 4. X plus 4. We're going to arrange the denominator the same way. So on the denominator, we have x minus 2 paired with x minus 5. We arrange it the same way. X minus 3 paired with x minus 4. And this is equal to 1. Very good. Very good. So now let's multiply. So we have x times x is x squared plus x times 5, that's 5x, and then 2 times x, that's 2x, and then 2 times 5, that's 10. So this is the result we got from multiplying the first two terms. Now let's multiply the other two terms. So this is x times x, that's x squared, and then x times 4, that's 4x, and then 3 times x, that's 3x, then 3 times 4 is 12. Very good. All over. Now let's multiply the denominator. So we have x times x, that's x squared, and then x times minus 5, that's minus 5x. Negative 2 times x is negative 2x. And then negative 2 times negative 5 is plus 10. Very good. Now let's multiply this other two terms. So x times x is x squared. And then x times negative 4 is negative 4x. Negative 3 times x is negative 3x. And then negative 3 times negative 4 gives plus 12. Very good. Very good. Now, our next step will be for us to simplify what we have inside of the bracket. So we have, this is x squared. And then 5x plus 2x is 7x, and then plus 10. Then in this other bracket, we have x squared. 4x plus 3x is 7x. Then 12 is same as 10 plus 2. Well, I did this because this is x squared plus 7x plus 10. I want this expression to be here as well as x squared plus 7x plus 10. You can see they are common. Now, all over, I'm going to be doing the same thing to the denominator. So on the denominator, we have x squared. Negative 5x, negative 2x is negative 7x. And then plus 10. Very good. Times, this is x squared. negative 4x, negative 3x is negative 7x. Then this is plus 12. Now, plus 12 is same as plus 10 plus 2. So 10 plus 2 gives 12. Very good. So you notice that what I have here is common to what I have here. And this is equal to 1. Very good. Very good. And now, since we have a common expression here, which is x squared plus 7x plus 10, the same as here, we're going to introduce substitution. So we can say, let this expression, which is x squared plus 7x plus 10, be equal to a. And then we'll do the same thing to the denominator. This expression here is also here. So I'll say, let x squared minus 7x plus 10, which is a common expression on the denominator, be equal to b. Now let's simplify this now. So this becomes a times, this is from here to the 10 is a. So this is a plus 2. So a plus 2. Sorry for that. So I'm going to be writing 2 here. Very good. All over the denominator, this expression is b from a substitution. So this is b times, from here to the 10 is b, and then plus 2. So this is b plus 2. Very good. Equal to 1. Now our next step will be for us to cross multiply. So cross multiply, I'll have a times a plus 2 to be equal to b times b plus 2 times 1 gives the same thing, b times b plus 2. Very good. So now let's open up the bracket. So we have a times a, which gives a squared, plus a times 2, that's 2a, equal to b times b, that's b squared, plus b times 2 is 2b. Very good. Very good. Now our next step will be for us to move what we have on the right hand side to the left hand side. So this is a squared. I'm going to be moving the b squared first. So this is, when b squared crosses to the left, it becomes minus b squared. So this is me bringing out the terms with the squares together. And then I have plus 2a here. And when I move 2b to the left, it becomes minus 2b. Now this is equal to 0. Very good. Now notice that we have an expression in difference of two squares. Difference of two squares can be expressed as a minus b times a plus b. Very good. So this is the difference of two squares expressed in this form. And then plus, now let's factorize what we have here. You notice that 2 is common, so we can factor out 2, open brackets. So 2a divided by 2, I have a, minus 2b divided by 2, I have b. And close brackets, equal to 0. Very good. Very good. Now notice that a minus b is common, so we can factor out a minus b, and then open brackets. So a minus b times a plus b divided by a minus b, I'll have a plus b plus 2 times a minus b divided by a minus b, I'll have 2. Very good. And this is equal to 0. So we have two cases here. The first case, we have a minus b to be equal to 0. And then the other case, I have a plus b plus 2 to be equal to 0. So we're going to be solving these cases one after the other. So for the first case, let me call this case 1. I have a minus b to be 0. So what I'm going to do is, let me just write it here, a minus b to be 0. You notice that I can actually bring out the substitution. What is a? A is x squared plus 7x plus 10 minus b. And what is b? B is x squared minus 7x plus 10. Very good. And this is equal to 0. Now let's open up the brackets. So we have x squared plus 7x plus 10. Now use this negative to open up. We have minus x squared. Now negative times negative makes positive 7x. And then negative times positive makes negative 10. And this is equal to 0. And now simplifying further, you see that x squared minus x squared is gone. And then 10 minus 10 is gone. So what I have left is 7x plus 7x, which results to 14x. And this is equal to 0. Very good. Now to get the value of x, I'm going to divide both sides by 14. So divide both sides by 14. So 14 cancels out, leaving x to be equal to, now 0 divided by 14 is 0. Very good. So now let's pay attention to our case 2. So case 2. And what is our case 2? Our case 2 is a plus b plus 2 is equal to 0. Remember our substitution. What is a? A is x squared plus 7x plus 10. That's a. And then plus b. What is b? B is x squared minus 7x plus 10. So that's b. And then plus 2. So plus 2 equal to 0. Very good. So now let's add up like terms. So x squared plus x squared gives 2x squared. And then 7x minus 7x cancels out. And then 10 plus 10, that's 20. Plus 2 is 22. So plus 22 equal to 0. Very good. So our next step will be for us to move 22 to the right hand side. And when we do that, we have 2x squared to be equal to, as 22 crosses to the right, it becomes negative 22. Now we need to isolate x squared by dividing both sides by the coefficient 2. So divide both sides by 2. So 2 can cancel out 2, leaving behind x squared to be equal to, now negative 22 divided by 2 gives negative 11. Very good. Very good. Now, in order for us to get the value of x, we have to take the square root of both sides. So I'll take the square root of x squared. This is equal to, well, this will result to plus or minus the square root of the right-hand side, which is negative 11. Now, notice that square root cancels out square, leaving behind x to be equal to plus or minus the square root of negative 11 is same as 11 times negative 1. And if we have to separate, you see that x will be plus or minus the square root of 11 times the square root of negative 1. We all know that negative 1 is I, which is iota. So that means the value for x is plus or minus the square root of 11i. And there are two values of x here. So the two values of x, if I have to separate, remember we've got one value before, that x, which is the first value, is 0. That means the second value from here will be plus, which is the positive 1, will be the square root of 11i. And then the third value of x will be the negative of the square root of 11i. And these are our final answers. Well, feel free to share your ideas in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video and have learned something from this video, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't. Turn on the notification bell so you don't miss my upcoming videos. And like I always say, until next time, take care.